So far, we have learned about types, terms, equality types, paths, but there is one special type without which none of this would be possible. Something type theorists refer to as a universe. A universe is a type whose terms are themselves types. In fact, by definition, every type we can think of must inhabit a universe, including universes themselves. Therefore, every universe inhabits an even bigger universe, such that we have an infinite series of universes nested within each other. The power of these universes becomes evident when we use them in conjunction with functions. But how do we implement functions in type theory? Well, to start off, we have something called a function type. For instance, let's consider the function type a arrow b. We say that the function f inhabits this function type if f maps every term of a to a term of b. You may be thinking, no big deal. We do this in mathematics all the time. But something interesting happens when we map not to an ordinary type, but to a universe. The functions inhabiting this type are called type families. Suppose we had a type family, capital F. F would then map every term of A to some type. But we can go one step further. Not only can we map to a type in a type family, we can map to a term in a type family. But to understand how this is done, we need to take a look at an indispensable tool used by type theorists, the pi type. Using the pi type, we can construct a new kind of function type, one that redefines our very definition of a function. For example, we can construct a function g that takes every term in its input x to a term in fx. In other words, the output type depends on the input term. And thus we have a new breed of functions that transcend the realms of ordinary functions. We call them dependent functions. Thanks for watching.